Hey guys, welcome to our channel, Chill on YouTube. Whether it's a ring, a bracelet, earrings, or a necklace, diamonds can take your look to the next level. You can go from simple to glam in seconds with the help of a few dazzling adornments. Diamonds are revered and are commonly seen as a symbol of commitment, being the stone of choice for engagement and wedding rings. If you're in the market for a new diamond, you may have heard about lab-grown diamonds, but it can all be a bit confusing. Lab-grown diamonds are also created using extreme pressure and heat, but inside a machine rather than the bowels of the earth. There are two ways to grow a diamond. Both involve starting the seed, a flat slither of another diamond. Here's everything you need to know about how lab-grown diamonds are made. So guys, let's get started. What are lab-grown diamonds? Regardless of what you call them, lab-grown diamonds are known by many names. Lab-grown diamonds, cultured diamonds, man-made diamonds, synthetic diamonds, etc. They certainly have cut into the market share of the diamond industry. So, what are they? Simply put, they are diamonds grown in a lab. These labs use cutting-edge technology to replicate the natural process to create diamonds found in the earth. The result is incredible. Lab-created diamonds are not fakes. They're not cubic zirconians. They have the same physical and chemical properties of a mined diamond, stated Stephen Morisot, a spokesperson for the Gemological Institute of America, a nonprofit organization that oversees the International Diamond Grading System. Lab-created versus mined. Lab-grown diamonds are manufactured using conditions that mimic the natural process that creates earth-grown diamonds. This means that carbon is subjected to high temperatures and high pressure in a controlled environment, kind of like this studio. I'm gonna be a diamond as soon as I'm done with this video. Diamonds pulled from the earth are thought to have been formed 1 to 3 billion years ago. However, scientists believe they were formed from carbon dioxide being exposed to extreme temperatures over 2000 Fahrenheit and extreme pressure about 727 pounds per square inch. These conditions are found approximately 90 miles below the Earth's surface. Once formed, these diamonds were moved from the Earth's core to its crust by volcanic explosions. The process of making a diamond in a lab is much more efficient. Labs use two different methods to grow diamonds: high pressure, high temperature, HPHT, and chemical vapor deposition, CVD. But can you make a diamond at home? That's the real question. Before we talk about how humans are making diamonds, let's dive into the benefits of lab-grown diamonds. Number one, less expensive. The price of a lab-created diamond tends to be less than mined diamonds. However, this does not mean that the lab-created diamonds are cheap. The capital costs for lab-grown and mined diamonds are pretty similar. So why are lab-created diamonds less expensive? Mined diamonds and lab-created diamonds have the exact same cost when it comes to cutting, polishing, and inspection. However, up to that point, the costs and processes are very different. Number two, environmentally kind. As with the mining of any natural resource, diamond mining has a significant impact on the environment. To be fair, diamond mining companies are fully aware of the impact and have taken steps to try to minimize the effect they have on the ecosystem around them. However, lab-created diamonds are inherently and significantly less detrimental to the environment, as it takes considerably less energy to grow a diamond in a lab than it does to dig it out of the ground. It is actually in the interest of the growers to minimize the amount of energy they use in the process to save money and decrease their costs. Number three, socially responsible. One of the major benefits of lab-grown diamonds is that you know exactly where the diamond originated. Many traditional mined diamonds come from conflict regions. This has raised both ethical and humanitarian concerns. The diamond industry has been linked to child labor, poor working conditions, human rights violations, and funding armed conflicts. With lab-grown diamonds, you can have peace of mind knowing your diamond wasn't involved in the blood diamond trade. Alright, are you ready to make a diamond? Let's talk about the known processes of making a diamond. Number one, high pressure, high temperature, HPHT. Scientists have been synthesizing diamonds for decades, producing the first gem quality stones in 1950. The original method was known as high pressure, high temperature, or HPHT, which simulates the crushing force of the earth by applying high temperature and high pressure alongside a metal catalyst to dissolve carbon into a diamond seed. Temperatures can go as high as 3000 degrees Celsius or more than 5000 degrees Fahrenheit. Number two, chemical vapor deposition. A newer process uses low pressure and smaller machines. an approach that is easier for scientists to control and monitor. As a result, CVD is increasingly favored over HBHT, particularly for the jewelry market. It uses a vacuum chamber that is filled with hydrogen and methane to provide the source of carbon. The gas is turned into plasma at extremely high temperatures, releasing carbon pieces, which are then layered onto a diamond seed in the vacuum chamber. The process is not dissimilar to 3D printing. Number 3. Crockpot. While homemade diamonds are not a reality today, who knows what the future holds? Wink, wink. Alright guys, that's the end of this video. Lab-grown diamonds are real and inexpensive. We hope you really enjoyed it. Thanks for watching. But before you go, subscribe, like, and share the video. And don't forget, hit that bell icon to check out more interesting videos made just for you.